would like to talk about the email setup in Salesforce. We see a lot of our customers having no setup for emails in Salesforce, and then when they start sending out emails from Salesforce, it ends up in their customer's spam, in their receiver's spam folder. So what I say is the first thing you do when you set up Salesforce, make sure the email settings are correct so that your emails from Salesforce do not end up as spam. For this, you have to do two things. First of all, you have to set up the DKIM, which is the domain keys identified mail. I will not go into detail, just have a picture on that later on. And then you have to set up SPF, Sender Policy Framework. Okay, what are these two things? So the DKIM setup actually makes sure that Salesforce is allowed to send emails and that the receiver email server can actually validate that these emails are sent from Salesforce. So the first thing to do is ask Salesforce to set up a public-private key pair and exchange these public keys to your DNS server. You probably have to ask your DNS administrator to set this up, but this is a very, very common action to take. So it can be set up in like 5 minutes. One meeting with your DNS admin, one meeting with your Salesforce admin, and then 5 minutes later, it's all set up. So I will show you how the setup is done in my company for this, and then you can just replicate that in your company. So every time now Salesforce will send an email, it will actually take the private key, create a signature. So on this email, it's verified via a signature that's created by this private key. And now when this email ends up on the receiver email service, this one will actually go and check, is the signature correct? Did nobody change the email message on their way? And is this actually coming from a source that I can trust? So what it's going to do is, it's going to check the from address. The from address is going to be pdfbutler.com. So I'm going to take the example as our company over here, PDF Butler. And as the source address, it will check out a certain record on the DNS server and ask for, can I get the public key? And then with this public key, it's going to verify the signature. And if that's okay, it's going to forward this email message to the inbox of the receiver. If this is not okay, or there is no setup done for PDF, the domain pdfbutler.com, it will actually maybe decide, hey, I don't trust this. I'm going to forward it to the spam folder of the receiver. So when it's ended up in the spam folder, of course, that's exactly what you do not want. So long story short, make sure that your domain name, in our case pdfbutter.com, is set up correctly and that there is a key exchange done between Salesforce and your domain name. Okay, that's the DKIM setup. We will go through in we'll see it in Salesforce and in our DNS environment in a minute. Next up is SPF. So the SPF setup is actually an action on top of the DKIM. So it's two passages that it's going to take to check if everything is okay. Should I not see this as spam? Is the sender trustworthy? Do I have to trust this sender? Because what's happening here is that actually we're asking Salesforce.com to send out emails from a certain domain name, in our case, pdfbutler.com. And of course, Salesforce is not PDF Butler. That's why we have to add this security. So what we're going to do here is we're going to ask our domain name administrator. We're going to ask him to allow all Salesforce mail servers to send out emails from this domain pdfbutter.com. So when Salesforce sends an email next to the DKIM that we just saw, it's also going to check if this email comes from a server that's trustworthy. So it knows that it's coming from Salesforce. So it's the receiver email service will actually now check on the DNS, on the domain, is Salesforce trustworthy? And if your setup is correct, it will say, yes, Salesforce is trustworthy. So you can trust these mails coming from Salesforce. They are allowed to send emails from the domain name pdfbutler.com. Again, what happens is, well, it will forward the email on towards the inbox of the receiver instead of categorizing it as spam. So both the DKIM setup and the SPF setup will actually make sure your emails are seen as valid emails and are not seen as spam. Okay, next up, we do with the theory and we're actually going to see it in practice. Now, let's take a look how to actually create this DKIM and SPF setup. First of all, let's go into Salesforce Setup, search for DKIM. The entire explanation of what I'm going to do right here is actually also documented by Salesforce, as you would expect. I will make sure these URLs are on our Academy, so you can easily jump through them. So we're just going to follow this step by step, and then we'll see what happens. So first step is we have to create a new key. On the key, I'm going to select a certain selector. So it's just, let's say, demo movie dkim1.pdfbutler.com. Yeah, and then I'm going to actually just copy that one. So I'm just going to copy this. And for the alternate, I'm going to just say the two. So it's just two items that you need to put here. So that's fine. Then the domain, in our case, it's pdfbutler.com. And I want to allow subdomains of the domain only. So I want to allow domains and subdomains. So, okay, this is something you have to review inside your company and see what's actually going on and what actually people would expect from this setup. Okay, cool. Let's save. And now our setup is done. So, next thing is we have to go wait until the record has been generated. So we have to wait for a few seconds. Normally it goes really fast. So let's go and take a look. Yep, they're already there. So I'm not going to blur out these keys because I'm just going to remove them directly afterwards. So what you have to do now is go to your domain name server. So your environment where you manage your domain. In our case, our domain is pdfbutler.com and our domains are managed by AWS. There are millions of domain providers out there. Doesn't matter which one you have, but in general, they all work the same. So you're going to have to create a new record, as they call it, on your domain name. So just going to click the button to create the new record. And then I just have to copy paste from what Salesforce puts here. So they put here a bunch of information, and then at the end it says pdfbutler.com. Now, I'm only going to copy this. Why? Because AWS already adds pdfbutler.com at the end. So I don't want it there twice. So that's what it will do. Now, it's going to be a CNAME, so the type of the record in our DNS example. And the value, so it also says that it's here, CNAME. And the value is this one. So we have to copy this one. And don't forget to copy the dot at the end. It's not the end of the sentence, but it's also part of the value. Cool. Now, okay. Yep. I paste this here. All the rest of the information, I have no idea what it does. I'm just going to leave it as it is. So you're the main administrator might handle this stuff, and you can just have these set up the way you want to. Now, I'm not going to create a record because this is just a demo, but just click create record and all is fine. You do the same for the second one, and then it's a waiting game. So when this is all done, you can just click the activate button. Yeah? And when it's active, it's actually going to check if it's really active and that the domain names are there or configured correctly, and then you can check the activate button. So that means if the setup is not done correctly, the activate button will not show. So yeah, make sure that yeah you work together with your domain name administrator to activate these keys. Now, I have some keys already here, so I will blur these ones out, but you see these are published and these are active. So everything is fine for this one. From this environment, I can do my demos now and I can start sending out emails from my from myself, igor.stuyver@pdfbutter.com. Okay, cool. That's step one. Step two for the SPF. Also, that has an article in Salesforce. So I will also make sure it's on our academy. But for this, you don't have to do anything in Salesforce. It's all in your DNS environment, so your domain name environment. So same thing here. You're going to have to create a new record. The new record doesn't really matter. How is it called? So you, yeah, you actually don't have to. You just can say Salesforce.com SPF, for instance. Then the type is going to be a text record here. So okay, and then the value you can just copy paste from this article here. So if your domain name administrator wants to be sure that you only have an org, Salesforce org in Europe, for instance, and they only want to have the IP addresses of that org or of that environment, you can make it really complicated like this one. But yeah, in general, most will just go for this one and say, well, when it comes from Salesforce, I will just trust all of them. So add this one right here as a value, and then boom, that's done. That's all that needs to be done. So yeah, that's when I click create record here, our setup is already done, and we can just now send out emails from from Salesforce without them ending up in the spam folder. Okay, hope you liked it, hope you thought it was interesting, and hope you have now all the information to send out emails from Salesforce.